The dot matrix printer was invented by Robert Howard. It became first commercially available in the early 1970s. The printhead has many pins on it. These pins are controlled by electromagnets, and when the printhead strikes down, the pins force an ink ribbon on the paper. Ultimately, it made creating and copying documents easier. Thus, it made businesses and institutions far more efficient, automating many jobs.
It's more sophisticated, yet less complicated.
George H. Hellmeyer, an American engineer, invented the liquid crystal display. Like the dot matrix printer, it became commercially available in the early 1970s. LCDs scatter light rather than producing it. They do this by creating dark areas that can be seen in illuminated environments by reflection, making them very power efficient. This discovery revolutionized televisions and monitors. Because LCDs drew significantly less power, American families saved money. Further, they enabled the creation of the handheld calculator. Working for Atari, Alan Alcorn created the Pong arcade game. Pong, based on tennis, was a hit, fueling the arcade industry. 10 years after its creation, hundreds of arcade games had been made, and thousands of Americans played them, creating a massive industry.
Games are actually split up into pieces, and one has to.
Herb Boyer of the University of California at San Francisco and Stanley Cohen of Stanford University were the first people to splice genes, or a process by which a segment of DNA is attached to or inserted into a strain of DNA from another source. Boyer and Cohen inserted viral DNA fragments into the bacterial DNA. This enabled scientists to create bacteria that produced human hormones, such as insulin. Therefore, this discovery saved millions of lives, lowering the cost and the danger of hormones.
We now put in a radio pulse with a frequency that will cause the disease.
Raymond Damadian, an American physician, invented magnetic resonance imaging in 1977. MRI machines using strong magnets and radio waves are very versatile and provide highly refined images without invasive surgeries. Additionally, few things can obstruct the scan. Because of its versatility, magnetic resonance imaging has saved countless American lives, a landmark discovery in medicine. Martin Cooper, while working for Motorola, invented the first cell phone in 1973, the Motorola Dynatac. The Dynatac Dynamic Adaptive Total Area Coverage System enabled Americans to communicate anywhere, changing the way we interact.
Sony introduces the only cassette player as small as a...
Created in 1979, the Sony Walkman was the first portable music player and was very popular in the United States and enabled Americans to be entertained on the go, changing their lifestyle.
Working on a mail program, but it was programmed for a single computer.
Email was invented by Ray Tomlinson, an engineer at the Boston firm of Bolt, Baranek, and Newman. The first email or message distributed by electronic means from one computer user to one or more was sent in 1971. It said QERTYIOP or QERTYIOP. The first email was sent using ARPANET or Advanced Research Projects Agency Network. ARPANET, originally designed for research centers, was developed in 1966 by the Advanced Research Projects Agency and was the precursor to the Internet. Ultimately, the invention of the email revolutionized communication, making it easier and faster to send messages. No longer did one need to send messages using mail, the email connecting people together. Currently, millions of Americans use email, showing the significance of the invention. The digital camera was invented by Steve J. Sasson, an electrical engineer and alumni of Rensselaer Polytechnic Institute. Sasson created the first digital camera at the Applied Research Lab at Eastman Kodak. He invented it after studying charge-coupled devices for a year. The camera was created in 1974. Sasson used a Fairchild CCD, or a light-sensitive integrated circuit that stores and displays data for an image in such a way that each pixel in the image is converted into an electrical charge to convert the image into storable data. Said storable data was placed on a digital tape, saving the image. The final product weighed 10 pounds. And was the size of a toaster. The digital camera made taking and producing images very easy. One no longer needed to buy film and develop photos. Thus, American families and photographers were eager to buy them, making photography a larger industry. Further, saving memories became one of America's major hobbies, changing American life. In 1969, Nippon Calculating Machine Corporation, a calculator manufacturer, asked Intel to design 12 custom chips for its Busicom 141PF printing calculator. Intel suggested 4 chips instead of 12, which led to the creation of the first microprocessor. The founders of Intel, Robert Noyce and Gordon Moore, originally worked at Fairchild Semiconductor. Noyce was the general manager, while Moore was the head of research and development. In July of 1968, they resigned and founded Intel. Both men put $250,000 into the new company, and Intel began to manufacture memory chips. They created 4 chips for Nippon Calculating Machine Corporation, called MCS4, which were released on November 15th, 1971. One of the chips, the CPU, was the Intel 4004, the world's first microprocessor, or multi-purpose programmable device, that accepts digital data as input, processes it according to instructions stored in its memory, and provides results as output. It was 1/8 of an inch by 1/16 of an inch and had 16 pins and 2300 transistors etched into the silicon. The other chips were the read-only memory for custom applications, the random access memory for processing data, and the shift register chip for the inputs and outputs. The Intel 4004 was a building block that engineers could purchase and then customize software to perform different functions in a wide variety of electronic devices. It enabled engineers to build small, affordable, and powerful computers. Businesses, families, and institutions began to buy them, using computers for knowledge, entertainment, and more. Thus, it greatly changed American life.
Okay, Houston, we've had a problem here.
This is Houston, say again.
James A. Lovell from Cleveland, Ohio, was the mission commander. He graduated from the United States Naval Academy and was chosen as the second group of astronauts in 1962. Before Apollo 13, he was the command pilot for Gemini 9, command pilot for Gemini 12, and command module pilot for Apollo 8. John L. Swigert from Denver, Colorado, was command module pilot. He attended the University of Colorado in 1953 and Rensselaer Polytechnic Institute in 1965, receiving a degree in mechanical engineering and a master in aerospace science. In 1966, he was picked in the fifth group of astronauts. 72 hours before the launch, Swigert was moved from backup command module pilot to prime. Fred W. Hayes from Biloxi, Mississippi, was lunar module pilot. He attended the University of Oklahoma and received a Bachelor of Science in Aeronautical Engineering in 1959. Later, in 1966, he was chosen in the fifth group of astronauts. He was the backup lunar pilot for Apollo 8 and Apollo 11. To launch, Apollo 13 used the Saturn V, a massive rocket. The spacecraft consisted of three major parts: the service module, the command module, Odyssey, and the lunar module, Aquarius. It was very similar to the one used for Apollo 12, though improvements were made. The service module provided and stored consumables such as oxygen, water, and power. Further, it was intended to serve as the primary maneuvering and propulsion system. The command module served as the crew quarters and control center. It was equipped with couches and could accommodate three crew members. Further, it was designed for re-entry. The lunar module was designed for landing on the moon and taking off. It was intended to support two astronauts. Apollo 13 was the third lunar manned mission. It launched from Kennedy Space Center on April 11, 1970. Afterwards, halfway to the moon, disaster struck. On April 13, 1970, an explosion shook the command module of Apollo 13. The explosion was caused by a fire, sparked by faulty wiring in the oxygen tanks. It resulted in the destruction of many key systems. To return, the three-person crew moved into the lunar module, which was designed to support two men for 2 days and set the temperature to just above freezing to conserve energy for the 3.5-day journey. Then, they orbited around the moon, using gravity to return home. The crew splashed down in the ocean on April 17, 1970, and were unharmed. This event brought the danger and difficulties of space exploration to the attention of the American public, though Americans were optimistic. Moreover, it changed their lives because they realized space exploration was dangerous but possible.
Jim, did you get the vice on right?
David R. Scott, born in San Antonio, Texas, was mission commander. He attended the United States Military Academy in 1954 and the Massachusetts Institute of Technology in 1962, receiving a degree in aeronautics and astronautics. He was selected in the third group of astronauts in 1963. Further, he was the pilot of Gemini 8 and command module pilot of Apollo 9. James B. Irwin, born in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, was lunar module pilot. He attended the United States Naval Academy in 1951 and the University of Michigan in 1957. In 1966, he was selected from the fifth group of astronauts. Before Apollo 15, he was the backup lunar module pilot for Apollo 12. Alfred M. Worden, born in Jackson, Michigan, was command module pilot. He attended the United States Military Academy in 1955 and the University of Michigan in 1963, receiving degrees in astronautical and aeronautical engineering and instrumentation engineering. He was selected from the fifth group of astronauts in 1966. In addition, he was backup command module pilot for Apollo 12. Apollo 15 was the fifth lunar manned mission. it launched from Kennedy Space Center on July 26, 1971. Primary objectives included activating surface experiments and evaluating the capability of the Apollo equipment to provide extended lunar surface stay time. Apollo 15 was the first mission to use the lunar rover. It was a four-wheeled, manually controlled, electrically powered vehicle, and it carried the crew and their equipment. Moreover, it enabled the crew to travel long distances. Apollo 15 returned on August 7, 1971. The mission demonstrated that humans could stay on the moon for long periods of time and travel far on it. Thus, it changed American life because it fueled the belief that humans could live on the moon.